Hello everyone, in this video, I'll show you how to create a 3D mod for Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Impact. First of all, you need to download a program for that. You can find the link in the description to this video. I created a folder on the C drive and called it Asset. It's important that paths contain only English characters. Put the program that you downloaded here. Let's open the command line and go to this folder. Let's try to launch our program and see if it outputs anything. You can see the list of commands and their arguments. We'll start by exploring the exporting functionality. I copied an asset file and created a folder called export. This asset file comes from one of my mods that adds new maps to the game. I will leave the link in the description. Let's type the export command and specify the input and output paths. By default, the asset is exported in the GLB format. Remember, you can change the format with the optional if argument. Then press enter and wait a little until program finishes its execution. After that, you can open the exported asset with Blender. That's the program that we are going to use in this tutorial. By the way, my operating system is Linux, so I'll switch to it from now. I hope you understood how to use the program on Windows. Sometimes models are not located at 00, so let's move the viewport a little. Scroll and press the mouse wheel while holding the shift key. We exported a map asset, and with it a collision model was exported as well. Let's take a look at it. Good, now let's try to export an animated character. I will use Maldora's asset from my 3D skins mod. The process of exporting remains the same. Specify the input and output paths and just wait. It's important to set bone direction to Blender, otherwise the imported skeleton might be changed, sometimes corrupted. In order to view animations, we will switch to the Dopeship pane, Action Editor. Click on the skeleton, and then select an animation you want to view from the list. To play it, press space. You might also want to set the frame rate to 30 frames per second for more accuracy. Now let's explore the importing functionality. We'll start by importing a simple object, like Susan the monkey. Let's scale down it a bit and move. Then we will click Ctrl A and apply transformations. Now we're going to export our model. For exporting, I recommend using the Filmbox format, FBX. Don't forget to check the Apply Transform option. Now we're going to go back to the command line. Type the import command and specify the input and output path. And once again, I'm going to use my mod as the base to replace an asset. It replaces a crate for another crate, and we are going to replace it by our monkey. As you can see, our monkey is just black. It happened because by default our asset uses static lighting. The sources for this type of lighting are ambient colors and vertex colors. Our asset doesn't have any vertex colors and Blender's exporter set the ambient channel to zero. Let's try and fix it. When we imported our asset, another file was generated. A JSON configuration file. I recommend that you rename it first, although I didn't do that. Let's specify path to this file and then open it. I'm going to change the ambient value to a grayish color. Save the configuration. Run the import command once more and don't forget to replace the old file with the new one. Great. Now let's paint our monkey. We are going to use vertex colors for that. Open Blender, press Ctrl Tab and select Vertex Paint. Export the asset again. Run the import command and replace the old file with the new one. Perfect. Our monkey looks more fun now. In general, vertex colors are a great tool that can be used in some creative ways. For instance, you can fake shadows with it or ambient occlusion. Let's try use dynamic lighting now. To do that, we will need to edit JSON configuration again and activate a certain option. Save the configuration, run the import command, and replace the file. Looks great, but our vertex colors are gone now. To bring them back, we need to activate another option. Keep in mind that with these two options activated, some material properties like ambient or diffuse colors will be ignored and replaced by vertex colors. Also, our monkey looks a little bit sharp. To change it, we are going to open Blender again. Right-click on our monkey and select the Shade Smooth option. Nice. Now let's try something a little bit more interesting, importing a new map. First, I'm going to export a map from my mod. As you can see, this map doesn't really have proper collision since it was only used in cutscenes. We're gonna fix it. After exporting, delete the original file. Now we're going to import this asset back. When importing an asset, we can specify path to an asset that is going to be used for collisions. However, we are not going to use this collision asset. Instead, we're going to use the main exported asset. It worked as you can see. However, this method is not perfect and can lead to some little glitches. I recommend that you create a proper collision asset manually. That's all for today. I hope that you learned something new. We're going to explore this tool further in the next video. See ya!